From UFOs to ghosts and psychic powers, history is riddled with unexplained events. You can turn back now and learn the stuff they don't want you to know. Here are the facts. The Vatican secret archives are located in the heart of Vatican City. They contain more than 50 miles of shelves. According to the Vatican, the oldest documents here come from the 8th century CE, and from the 11th century on, the Church has kept a more or less continuous chronological archive. Within this archive, you'll find a note from Genghis Khan's grandson, demanding tribute. You'll also find letters from Michelangelo, and a note carved on birch bark from Native Americans. Despite their mysterious reputation, it's not impossible to enter these archives. It's just very, very difficult. Since 1881, they have been open to select academics, and internet users can take a virtual tour of the area. There are even occasional site tours held for journalists and the public. However, there's no browsing allowed. If you want to find something in the archives, you have to know what it is you're looking for and ask for it specifically. Therefore, no one outside the church knows exactly how many documents are in the archives. So what exactly do they have in there? Here's where it gets crazy. We're not sure. Conspiracy theorists believe the Vatican holds all sorts of secret materials, ranging from the outright bizarre to the disturbingly plausible. After all, conspiracy theorists have been accusing the Vatican of running the world for centuries, so it's only natural that they would assume the worst about these archives. For example, some conspiracy theorists believe that the archive holds secret information about Jesus Christ, gospels that contradict the modern Bible. These secret documents could allegedly refer to Jesus' biological descendants or scripture written in his own hand. Others believe the archives hold documents about the Church's involvement in various wars or banking scandals. Some even suggest that the Vatican holds the world's oldest and largest collection of pornography. Why would people believe these things? Most of the conspiracy theories about the Vatican's secret archives come on the shoulders of another conspiracy. For example, people who already believe the Catholic Church is attempting to control the United States would claim that they weren't crazy, that the answers were there all along, locked away in the archives. Before people could access these records, this type of claim held a lot of weight. When the Pope opened the archives to researchers, these claims did not disappear entirely, but there were certainly less people listening. The Catholic Church claims that all the excitement is about a misunderstanding of the archive's name. It is secret, in the sense that it is the Pope's private archive. This use of the word in Latin doesn't have the same connotation of intrigue that it has in English. In fact, most of the documents are administrative records and correspondences. But with the unprecedented popularity of Dan Brown's book, The Da Vinci Code, in which a scholar unravels a centuries-old conspiracy in the archives, people across the world took a new interest in the Vatican. Today, the Church has taken steps to repair the reputation of the secret archives by hosting limited tours with the press and also by publishing books with reproductions of certain documents. Yet the conspiracy theories still abound and grow as time goes on. Regardless of whether you're a skeptic or fully believe in one of these conspiracy theories, the fact remains, we have no idea what's actually buried in the archives. Until we do, speculation will run rampant. Because these secret archives are full of stuff they don't want you to know.